Hello there and welcome to this week's episode of Eye on Port. It is proudly brought to you by Ghana Community Network Services, that's GCNet, also Ghana Oil Company Limited, GOIL, and West Blue Consulting. The proud media partner is Business and Financial Times, Daily Graphic, Ghana Web, and also Maritime and Transport Digest. People, this week, it's very funny the way people freely in this country, people freely just flout the laws of our country and feel it's supposed to be normal. You know something? It is only the Ghana Ports and Harbours Authority that is mandated and empowered by the President of the Republic to build ports. But some Ghanaians, are fronting some foreign nationals and have decided to build their own ports in some corners of the coastal areas. They are building ports, not swimming pools. They are building ports, individuals and companies by themselves. They just get up and say, I import, I bring in cement, so I want to build my own port and bring cement. And Diamond Cement is one of them. Plus a lot of other companies, they are building their own ports. Ghana Ports and Harbours Authority says they will not let this happen. Whatever went wrong, that this had taken place, they are now clamping down on all these illegal ports that have been built by these corporations and individuals. A team of monitoring agencies comprising the police, the BNI, National Security, the Port Security, are embarking on this exercise. Take a listen. The Ghana Ports and Harbours Authority, led by its Director General, Paul Asariensa, is embarking on a severe clampdown on some individuals, corporations and private entities that are embarking on construction or development of smaller unauthorized port facilities along some coastal towns in the country. In this vein, the Director General of Ghana Ports and Harbours Authority, Paul Asariensa, has constituted a team which is led by the Port Security Manager, Lieutenant Colonel Nana Dakwa, and comprising the Ports Authority Monitoring Department, the Port Security, Ghana Navy, Ghana Marine Police, Ghana National Security, Bureau of National Investigations, and some journalists to investigate the practice of such entities who are constructing the illegal ports along the coast for the necessary actions to be taken. The first point of call by the team was at Anyanwi in the Keta Municipality of the Volta Region. Here, the team gathered that a fishing harbour called Omanye Ocean Fishing Company was about to be constructed with the help of some Chinese nationals. About 34 Chinese nationals had arrived at the site for the project.
They build a boat yard.
Boat yard. Build the same boat yard. And then they made the fishing processing
Again, 14 fishing vessels had also been procured from China for that project. Equipment to be used for the project had also been brought in containers. The project was said to belong to one Joe Onyame, who resides in Tema. The former assembly member in the Keta municipality, who's involved in the project, briefed the team.
They are coming to build their own coastal and everything.
So what processes are they going through now?
Yeah, they are going process through from marine transport to the Ministry of Fishery to the license is not yet.
He said the chiefs and elders of the community, including the Keta Municipal Assembly, had given their blessings for the project.
You don't have a license, then you bring people to the
office.
The team proceeded to the Keta Municipal Assembly, where the Municipal Chief Executive, Seth Yomewu, said even though he's aware such a project is going on, he hasn't been briefed because he was sworn into office not long ago.
We are 3 weeks now. I know they are doing something there. But as I'm here 3 weeks, I didn't have any record to see whether assembly have given them the
The fact-finding team also visited the Tema New Town, where an LPG storage facility is being constructed. Construction was said to have commenced in May 2016 and expected to be completed December 2017.
When did you start this project?
Last year.
A It was also revealed that the facility will soon be receiving oil and gas vessels.
Vessel will come and dock, and then it will supply. We put tanks here.
Do you know the oil
jetty?
You know there's an oil jetty in the port. I don't know about
that. Already 600 meters of breakwater had been constructed into the sea. The foreman of the project said permits had been obtained from Environmental Protection Agency, Ghana National Fire Service, Tema Metropolitan Assembly, and Ghana Maritime Authority. He said they have applied for permit from the Ghana Ports and Harbours Authority, but are yet to receive authorization. By virtue of the Ghana Ports and Harbours Authority Act, PNDC Law 160 of 1986, GPHA is the sole only governmental authority authorized and mandated to plan, build, develop, manage, operate and control port facilities in the country. Therefore, any port, harbor, marina, jetty or berth development related activity that is or is being carried out without due process and the formal consent and approval of the Ghana Ports and Harbors Authority as provided for under PNDC Law 160 of 1986 constitutes an illegality and subject to sanctions or prosecutions and other consequences. Well, so you see, is it not surprising that we are worried about some foreign nationals just coming into our country, building, digging, minerals and taking them away in the name of galamsey? Now we have them also coming in and building their own personal ports. They decide when to bring in fish, when to take the fish away. Whatever they decide to import or export is their own business. Look, this is not fair. So we decided to approach the Director General of Ghana Ports and Harbors Authority to find out exactly what has gone wrong to the extent that individuals and companies by themselves will just get up and begin to build their own ports. What has the Port Authority been doing all this while? And what do they intend to do going forward? The Director General. First of all, how did this get to the notice of the GPHA? And why did it take that long?
Now, in the first place, when I took over, I had one or two visits from people who claim that they have they've been in consultation with GPHA for some time to develop private port facilities. I said, wow, do you have any executive order to do it? He said, no, what is the executive order? So that was the wake-up call.
I see.
I realized that people were flouting the law in attempting to build private ports and harbors. Meanwhile, we are the state organization mandated to plan, to develop, to build, to operate, to maintain, and control ports and harbors in Ghana.
Only Ghana Ports and Harbors Authority.
Ghana Ports and Harbors Authority, according to the PNDC Law 160 of 1986.
I see.
Part 1, Section 1C. And that is an indication of how important the framers of the law consider development of port infrastructure to be.
Yeah.
So they put that final authorization in the hands of the president, and the president alone. It's the president alone through an executive instrument who can order the development of an enclave for port purposes or international trading purposes, right? And here are people
individuals,
yes, who just come and tell GPHA that we want to develop a port, and then they are going ahead.
Oh no, did they come to tell the Port Authority?
Some of them came to tell the Port Authority.
Say it and
only
then go back.
Exactly, but they must follow the due process of the law. Yes, the law says that it's only the president, right? So even if you come to consult the Port Authority, you don't have the authorization to go and develop a port.
But did the Port Authority at some point agree that yes, go and do it when they came to inform the
public? If they had the final authorization, they wouldn't be coming and be seeking the support of the port to develop their facilities.
Okay.
You know, the law gives us the mandate to do that, and in so doing, we could stretch our hands to the private sector to partner with us to develop the facility.
Like maybe you have done with MPS and all that, expanding the port space.
So the need could be identified by us as a port or the user, exactly, the private user. the need can be identified by him as well.
But partner like, with the authority.
Like people have come to identify the need for LNG gas, you know, reception facilities,
okay.
Right? And we are partnering with other people to develop the facilities for them, right? Because port development is an extremely important thing. Can you imagine a private individual developing an international airport in his backyard, right? And then
you have an aircraft,
because you have an aircraft or because you have money,
yeah,
and then you'll be flying in and out without recourse to the due process of law,
no.
That would be a recipe for a looming disaster,
yeah.
You know, can you imagine if somebody had such a private clandestine port? Can you imagine the implication to the drugs trade, for example?
Yeah.
Can you imagine the implication to the arms trade, for example?
The import and export of contraband goods.
Contraband goods, you know. And even now, look at the situation where people who deal in those things know how tight security is at the airport and at the port, and still they're able to risk it. So if people get to know that Ghana is so loose that they could come and build a private port, which will bring in goods in a ship, they will come and pretend like they are going into commercial port facility development. And before you realize, the trade in those illicit you know, goods have taken over the psyche of this country.
Yeah. Yeah.
Even look at the effort customs and ourselves are putting in to stop the illegal fuel trade, not to talk about stowaways, not to talk about the implication for terrorism.
Yeah.
No, it's a very risky thing. And so far, we sent our men in collaboration with the police, national security, to go around. So far, we've detected about 3 sites where people are into development of those facilities. We have issued circulars and notices and warnings in the national media and on social media, warning people like that to stop those illegal practices. And those who would be arrested, we've gone to caution and warn them. We are going to go around again. We are going to spread our reach also to the entire coastline of Ghana. Anybody who would be arrested would be prosecuted.
There was one company, for instance, that said they had seen the Maritime Authority. Is it the Maritime Authority or the other agencies that can any of them also do that issue?
The Maritime Authority does not issue permit for development of ports.
Okay.
Environmental Protection Agency does not issue permit for development of a port.
Shippers Authority.
Shippers Authority does not. And the Metropolitan Authorities do not.
Okay.
I'm saying that it is the President of Ghana who has the prerogative through an executive instrument. So the fact that you have cleared yourself with all this
agencies
is not an indication that you have the right to go ahead. We will arrest and prosecute you for flouting the law.
If you can share with us some of the people you are, because we saw in the papers and also the cameras picked up some of the companies that have already started, and how best we can deter or discourage others from joining.
Damos Cement is one of them. There's some Chinese the people who are also involved in developing one at a site in the Volta region, and then in Tema area,
yeah.
There are some people involved also developing some LNG, you know, facility and something like that.
Okay.
Yes, and there are other places. We believe there are other places where people are quietly developing such facilities. So we are going to go in the helicopter. We are going to fly along the west. I mean the entire coastline. Those anybody who would be caught still going ahead with such developments, we are going to prosecute you.
There were a number of issues that came up the last time this story came up, that why has it taken the Port Authority this long to address this?
Well, I cannot speak to that, and I don't want to go into that.
Okay.
As to why the authority was caught sleeping on its mandate. But I am taking responsibility for stopping the current situation. And I think I'm doing that as the acting director general.
Going forward, what signal is the Port Authority sending out there? What measures are you putting in place to tell all entities private or public, that you don't have the right to engage anybody to do ports or harbors.
The public education is one, and then regular engagement of stakeholder community. We are in the process of establishing the Port Community Association. That is the informal and yet legitimate platform for regular engagement with the stakeholder community. And through that, we'll be able to drive home the point that nobody has any authorization to develop a private port in Ghana here without recourse to the due process of law, without recourse to Ghana Ports and Harbours Authority that has the mandate to control ports in Ghana.
Okay, so action man Paul Asarianza has spoken. Beginning now, nobody will take it easy. Every illegal port everywhere is coming down, and the people involved prosecuted. Nice move there. Let's stay with the security at the ports and agencies led by the port security. Security agencies, for that matter, led by the port security, is undergoing some exercises to show how prepared they are to address any threats in the ports.
According to the International Maritime Organization's International Ship and Port Facility Security, ISPS code, there should be a comprehensive set of measures to enhance the security of ships and port facilities developed in response to perceived threats to ships and port facilities in the wake of the 9/11 attacks in the United States. In order to show compliance to the ISPS code, Ghana's Ports Security, in collaboration with the Ghana Armed Forces, Ghana Navy, National Security, Ghana Police Service, Bureau of National Investigations and Ghana Maritime Authority, has conducted a simulation exercise to test the preparedness of the security agencies to respond to threats. The exercise dubbed Hold Firm covered the various entry and exit points of the ports and the level of searches conducted at those ports. A scenario was also created of a suspicious bomb threat where the base ammunition depot from the Ghana Armed Forces were called to detonate the bomb after evacuating workers. The various security agencies pledged their commitment to ensure that the port becomes much secured for international trade.
It is also to make sure that we are very efficient and ready to, one, protect, detect, prevent and respond to any form of threat that we see in this port.
The port is a national hub, a national asset. If we don't provide enough security for the port, life at port will be unbearable for the citizen and the economy as well.
It is a coordination role, and we are all collaborating to make sure that the port is very safe.
All that I can say is constantly we should practice and try to see how we can have operational cohesion. We realize that it involved a lot of other emergency services like the fire service, ambulance, me coming in to render the thing safe, and the port security, the police cordon off and all that. If we don't rehearse, definitely we cannot get it together in a real situation.
And at long last, the much awaited board of directors of the Ghana Ports and Harbors Authority has been inaugurated.
The Minister of Transport, Kweku Ofori-Esiama, has inaugurated and sworn in an 11-member board of directors of the Ghana Ports and Harbours Authority. Members of the board include Paul Asarianza, Director General GPHA, Edward Osei, Director of Tema Ports, Captain Ebenezer Afizi, Director of Takrade Ports, and Chumesi Amkar Selvi, Chief Director, Ministry of Transport. Other members include Benanita Bismarck, CEO of Ghana Shippers Authority, Nana Dr. Apieje Dankwaso I, John Essel, Ghana Railway CEO, Honorable Eunice Jacqueline Bua, a member of Council of State, and Samuel Ahen, representing Staff Union of Ghana Sports and Harbors Authority. While Peter McMenu, the former chairman of the New Patriotic Party and immediate past chairman of the NPP campaign team, was appointed as the chairman of the Port Authority's Board of Directors. The Minister of Transport charged the new board to play its role to ensure the timely intervention of the ongoing expansion projects at the Port of Tema and Takrade to cater for the increasing volumes of cargo as well as handle bigger vessels.
I wish to urge the board to support the management to come out with very innovative measures and adopt best global practices to improve the both operational and financial performance of our port.
The Transport Minister entreated the board to come up with policies that will improve doing business at the ports. Peter McMenu, the board chairman of the GPHA Board of Directors, on behalf of the board said they will strive to initiate policies and programs that will reduce turnaround time of vessels, speed up cargo clearing, and improve general efficiency at the port.
The minister will promise to lead GPHA with exemplary set of leadership skills and position GPHA as a center of logistic excellence and efficiency, customer friendly, which is very important, and profit oriented and very, very viable, as you rightly indicated.
And at long last, the man who always says that he has sea in his blood has finally bowed out as the longest serving chief executive of our land, the chief executive officer of the Ghana Shippers Authority, Dr. Kofi Mbiah, has retired, and he has been replaced by Ms. Benonita Bismarck.
After a few weeks of stepping down as the chairman of the International Maritime Organization's legal committee in London, Dr. Kofi Mbiah has gracefully bowed out as the chief executive of the Ghana Shippers Authority after 35 years of service to the authority and Ghana, and also serving for 20 years as chief executive of the organization. Dr. Mbiah first announced his retirement when he addressed the 11th Maritime Law Seminar for judges of the Supreme Courts of Ghana in November 18, 2016. Dr. Kofi Mbiah has made significant contributions to the development of shipping in the West African sub-region. As chairman of the Union of African Shippers Councils and working with the Global Shippers Forum, he has been instrumental in dealing with a number of challenges facing shippers in the region. Dr. Kofi Mbiah, in his personal capacity, has also received several recognition as a beacon of excellence and for his commitment and dedication to duty at both national and international levels. Dr. Kofi Mbiah will be replaced by Mrs. Benonita Bismarck, a strategic planner and management consultant with experience in the shipping industry, as the new chief executive of the Ghana Shippers Authority.
So finally, Dr. Kofi Mbiah has retired. 35 years service to the Shippers Authority and over 19 years as chief executive of the same organization. At the appropriate time, we will be profiling him, as well as the lady who succeeds this huge figure of our land. I on port returns after the break.
Hello.
Good morning. This is Samantha Wendy. I am sending a purchase order from SAT Ventures International. Our policy for new supplies is 2 containers to start with, but you must deliver within 30 days.
Don't worry at all. I'm going to get you the 4 containers within 30 days or less.
Bye. To get his pineapple slices from his country to his clients overseas, Mr. Appiah and his representatives have to complete a number of regulatory compliance procedures to various international trade stakeholders.
Hey, Baba, what's going on? Catch it right? I mean, how? Hey.
Using single window, Mr. Appiah has completed all his international trade procedures through one portal. He has registered his company information, applied for the necessary permit, certificates and licenses, and all that remains is for him to get a text alert for clearance and movement of goods. And that's how simple facilitating international trade could be in a single window environment. You can offer competitive services to your trading partners in China, America, even here, in a simpler, faster, and cost-effective way. Single window, the only way to Ghana's economic growth, is in our hands.
When cleaning your vehicle by valeting, steaming, waxing, or polishing, make sure the engine is also sound. Servicing your vehicle with gold synthetic oil and any quality gold oil massages the engine, removes deposit, protects it from wear and tear for longer lasting performance, and makes your vehicle fuel pumped. Made for diesel and super engines. Remember, after every 15,000 kilometers of enjoying your ride, service your engine with Gold Synthetic Oil.
We are your champion. That's why I, Azuma Nelson, 3 times world boxing champion and a patriot. Always choose Goel.
Ashine Pankasa. Goel, good energy.
Buying cars in the port is cheaper than going to garage. So,
you
sure?
Trust me.
Trust me.
These two ladies are trying to steal my car.
Huh? Hold my bag. Hold my weight. You don't call me a thief.
We don't sell cars at the port.
Oh, but I bought this car and I have paid for it.
Down.
That thing might be dangerous. I'll go to care.
Just keep cool.
Because anything is sealed before I can see you.
The Ghana Ports and Harbours Authority says it has come to its attention that certain persons and bodies are pursuing the development of ports, harbours, berths, jetties or other similar forms of seafront facilities without recourse to the appropriate approvals and permits. By virtue of the GPHA Act PNDCL 160 of 1986, GPHA is a sole governmental authority authorized and mandated to plan, build, develop, manage, operate and control ports facilities in the country. The Ghana Ports and Harbours Authority has therefore advised individuals and entities who are desirous of developing any port or seafront facility to take the necessary steps in their own interest by contacting the GPHA for proper documentation, authorization, consent, approval, or otherwise. In a public announcement dated 24th May 2017, the authority warned that any port, harbour, marina, jetty, or berth development related activity that is or is being carried out without due process and the formal consent and approval of the GPHA as provided under the PNDCL 160 of 1986 constitutes an illegality and subject to sanctions and other consequences.
Welcome back from the break. Still watching Eye on Port and news and activities that are happening in and around the port and maritime industry is up next.
The maiden edition of the Ghana Shippers Awards has been slated for 30th of June 2017 at the Movenpick Ambassador Hotel at 6 p.m. The event, which is being organized by Globe Productions Limited in collaboration with the Gaffrick Business, seeks to recognize distinctions in the maritime field and also to promote the interests of the industry both nationally and internationally.
The aims and objectives of the Ghana Shippers Awards is to recognize excellence and achievement within the shipping industry. It also seeks to bring together all players within the shipping industry to network, share ideas, and have fun.
Speaking in an interview with Iron Ports, Latif Abubakar, Events Director of Global Production Limited, said the awards cut across road transportations, ocean carriers, air transportation, freight forwarding, shipping agents, express services, courier agencies, government agencies, insurance, financial institutions, and more.
We have other categories like the corporate social responsibility, innovative and technology company of the year, and so on and so forth. A full list of the categories can be found on our website, www.ghanashippersawards.com.
He said the awards will provide the platform to recognize individuals and companies that play a significant role in the growth and development of the industry, while recognizing the key functions within the industry that promote growth and sustainability.
A quality, well-executed awards and dinner night. The nominees should expect a quality, well-executed awards and dinner night. I'm telling you, it's not just about picking up the awards. It's about the networking, the sharing ideas, and then the fun. I mean, that we should also once in a while have outside our busy schedule.
The maiden of the Ghana Shippers Awards promises to be very exciting, particularly coming on the heels of the Vice President's call for all agencies, corporations and individuals to let their works at the port yield total efficiency in doing business in Ghana.
The Tema branch of the Ghana Chamber of Commerce has educated the business community on how to process certificates of origin during its third bi-monthly members meeting for 2017. This follows several concerns from exporters and freight forwarders with regards to the challenges they go through in processing their certificates of origin. A certificate of origin is a document used in international trade which is completed by the exporter and certified by a recognized issuing body attesting stating that the goods in a particular export shipment have been produced, manufactured, or processed in a particular country. The chamber, in collaboration with West Blue Consulting, is automating the certificate of origin on the Ghana National Single Window platform. Hitherto, the exporters and freight forwarders would have to make payments at the banks, go to the chamber to buy the certificates before returning to their offices to enter their detail, after which they come back to the chamber for signature and endorsement. This process was seen as cumbersome, which leads to the loss of productive time. But the certificate of origin has now been made electronic. Therefore, exporters can sit in the comfort of their offices and apply for it.
Certificate of origin is going to be electronic certificate of origin. So that's what we sought to educate the forwarders on today. So under this new process, the exporters and forwarders will be able to access a certificate of origin through at the comfort of their offices. They will go through their PCs and then apply for the certificate online, pay for it online, and then print it out and then send it for their importers outside Ghana.
This particular move is seen to be in the right direction, especially in the wake of calls by the Vice President for the ports of Ghana to go paperless by September 1st, 2017.
Hello.
Good morning. This is Samantha Wendy. I am sending a purchase order from SAT Ventures International. Our policy for new supplies is 2 containers to start with, but you must deliver within 30 days.
Don't worry at all. I'm going to get you the 4 containers within 30 days or less.
Bye. To get his pineapple slices from his country to his clients overseas, Mr. Appiah and his representatives have to complete a number of regulatory compliance procedures to various international trade stakeholders.
Hey, Grandma, what's going on? Catching right?
Using single window, Mr. Appiah has completed all his international trade procedures through one portal. He has registered his company information, applied for the necessary permit, certificates and licenses, and all that remains is for him to get a text alert for clearance and movement of goods. And that's how simple facilitating international trade could be in a single window environment. You can offer competitive services to your trading partners in China, America, even here, in a simpler, faster, and cost-effective way. Single window, the only way to Ghana's economic growth, is in our hands.
When cleaning your vehicle by valeting, steaming, waxing, or polishing, make sure the engine is also sound. Servicing your vehicle with gold synthetic oil and any quality gold oil massages the engine, removes deposit, protects it from wear and tear for longer lasting performance, and makes your vehicle fuel pumped. Made for diesel and super engines. Remember, after every 15,000 kilometers of enjoying your ride, service your engine with gold synthetic oil.
We are your champion. That's why I, Azuma Nelson, 3 times world boxing champion and a patriot, always choose Goel.
Ashine Pankasa. Goel, good energy.
Buying cars in the port is cheaper. Now go to garage. So,
you
sure?
Trust me.
Trust me.
These two ladies are trying to steal my car.
Oh, hold my bag. Hold my way. You don't call me a thief.
We don't sell cars at the ports.
Oh,
what on your mouth?
But I bought this car and I have paid for it.
Down. That thing might be dangerous, so I'll go to care.
Why do you
just keep cool? Because anything is same will go against you.
The Ghana Ports and Harbours Authority says it has come to its attention that certain persons and bodies are pursuing the development of ports, harbours, berths, jetties, or other similar forms of seafront facilities without recourse to the appropriate approvals and permits. By virtue of the GPHA Act PNDCL 160 of 1986, GPHA is a sole governmental authority authorized and mandated to plan, build, develop, manage, operate, and control ports facilities facilities in the country. The Ghana Ports and Harbours Authority has therefore advised individuals and entities who are desirous of developing any port or seafront facility to take the necessary steps in their own interest by contacting the GPHA for proper documentation, authorization, consent, approval, or otherwise. In a public announcement dated 24th May 2017, the authority warned that any port, harbour, marina, jetty, or berth development related activity that is or is being carried out without due process and the formal consent and approval of the GPHA as provided under the PNDCL 160 of 1986 constitutes an illegality and subject to sanctions and other consequences.
And schedules of vessels that are sitting in the port, those at anchorage, and also those expected in the coming week, plus the Bank of Ghana exchange rate are next. Next are your comments.
Ken Adamte Kujawu says, I think the treatment of the owner of the cranes is very bad. Hence, justice would have to be served. I think there are some mafias at stake. Kwame Inshura comments on the move by the Ghana Shippers Authority to wade into the missing cranes and says, if it is found out that GKL has the cranes, then they will have to cough it out. Customs as a body needs a house cleaning exercise.
That's it for Eye on Port for this week. We thank you for watching the program. Also, thanks to my man, Robert Nyantechi, Godwin Kabuti, Solomon Anderson, Joe Lavoe, also Flavia Amuesi, Victoria Mamea, Brian Richard, Michael Fumi as well, and the executive producers of the program, Abena Sewa Opokufusu and Paul Asariansa.